There are times when we struggle to feel united, encouraged, empowered, and equipped, set to do the very will of God. These are times when our accusers escort us to church, just like the woman's accusers escorted her to Jesus. You know the woman caught in the act of adultery? Now, you may not have been caught in the very act of adultery, and you may not see or physically feel woman's escorting you because you walk in here alone. But your accusers, those naysayers who are still in your head and your mind, are accusing you of all of these other things. Like, you didn't do enough for him, or you didn't care enough for her, or you didn't try hard enough to save them, imposing guilt and fear and shame and doubt. Well, Divine Movement stopped by to tell you that we serve a God who is not an accuser of the brethren. In fact, in the book of Revelation 12:10, and I heard a loud voice say in heaven, now is come salvation and strength, and the kingdom of our God, and the power of this Christ, his Christ, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. So remember what Jesus said to the woman after he wrote in the sand, causing her accusers to flee. He said, where are your accusers now? Jesus is asking you, my sisters, where are your accusers? Look to the right. Look to the left. Look in front of you. Look behind you. And seeing that there are none, be it resolved on this Wednesday, 2016, our Lord our God is holy, and we will lift him up and magnify his name. Be it resolved that on this day of our Lord, we will declare him as wonderful, glorious.